Did you know that more heart attacks happen at age 65 for men and 72 for women than any other age? Yep. And yet most people don't know how to avoid these heart attacks. We're going to tell you how today. It all starts by asking one simple question. Do you have arterial plaque, plaque in your arteries? My name is Ford Brewer. I'm a physician. I taught preventive medicine at Johns Hopkins and continue to do prevention. I've got over 40 years of clinical experience with patients. Today, I'll show you how to find arterial plaque at home using only a blood pressure monitor. Okay, so are you ready? Let's get started. Picture this. You're starting to feel some slight chest pain anytime you exercise, and you're also starting to feel a little bit weak with low energy. You go to the doctor, and she runs some tests. She tells you, hey, you know, you have high cholesterol, and that's dangerous because it'll get stuck in the arteries of your heart. So here, take this pill. Take a pill. You leave the room confused with a lot of questions like, why do I have cholesterol in my heart? And what did I do wrong? I'm taking better care of myself than I did when I was younger. So why am I sick? When your doc's talking about cholesterol, you should be thinking about plaque, arterial plaque. It's the real driver for heart attack and stroke risk. Maybe a little bit more, and in fact, a whole lot more than just cholesterol in your blood. But what is arterial plaque? Most people think plaque is a waxy, fatty substance inside the artery where the blood flows. That's wrong in a couple of key ways. Arterial plaque is a disgusting goop. It's like mucus or snot. And like mucus or snot, it's mostly inflammation, not cholesterol. This goop builds up in your arteries, and just like a pimple, if this inflammation ruptures, letting all that inflammation and liquid into the bloodstream, it causes a clot. It's a big clot, and it goes to the heart, that causes a heart attack. If it goes to the brain, that causes a stroke. Before starting any medication, I'd recommend testing for plaque. There are multiple ways to detect plaque, but only one can you do easily at home. The technique you will learn today is called ankle brachial index. Just a word of caution. If you already have been diagnosed with deep venous thrombosis or DVT, or if you have severe leg pain, in that case, skip this test. Now that you know why it's important, let's dive into how to test your ABI at home. Now we're going to actually take the video clip of me doing an ABI. I've got my blood pressure cuff. I've got a pen and paper, and I've labeled it left arm and ankle, right arm and ankle. I've got a couch to lay down on, and I've got an iPhone to diddle around with while I'm resting. So Jesus wants to make sure that I rest first. My blood pressure is usually the same whether I'm standing or lying down, but I'm gonna go ahead and rest because Jesus, the video director, wants me to do it. We want to get this up next to my artery, which is going through here. And so that needed to be undone. We want to pull it around firm, but not too tight, not really tight. Then we press the button. Okay, 107 over 69, right arm. Okay, take this off, Put it on my right leg. I was clearing thorns in a nearby woods a couple of weeks ago. That's why I've got all these scratches on my legs. I don't know why that didn't do that the first time we did this. The artery's going up through here. So that's where we want to put the air bladder. Oh, wait a minute. I have to wait for a minute for Dr. Vega. Jesus is requiring a lot of footage here. He's always requiring a lot. I can't really tell how it's doing yet. I know Jesus is nervous. And that is going to be that's it. I can tell you from looking at this already that it doesn't show a lot of evidence of plaque, which is not a surprise given the I certainly wouldn't expect to have enough plaque to cause problems in my legs with the hill sprints and things like that that I can do. That's it. All right. That wasn't too difficult, was it? If you haven't done it, don't worry. Pause the video. I'll wait until you get your numbers. All right. Let me show you how to calculate your results. These are my numbers. For my right arm, I got 107 over 69. For my left arm, 114 over 72. For my right ankle, 120 over 59. And for my left ankle, 126 over 74. By the way, the units are called millimeters of mercury, and that's just how high the pressure can push a column of mercury. The first number is called the systolic blood pressure. The systolic blood pressure reflects the pressure from the blood after the heartbeat. And the second number is the diastolic. It's when the heart is resting. So, this is how to calculate the index, the ankle brachial index. First, choose the highest systolic number from your ankles. In my case, that would be 126. Choose the highest systolic number from your arms. In my case, that would be 114. Now, you need to divide the numbers. 126 divided by 114, that would be 1.1. You might have noticed that's for my left leg, and you can do this for the other leg. For my right leg, that would be 120 over 114, resulting in 1.05. There are other methods to calculate this, but this is by far the simplest and easiest. Let's see what those results now mean. The ideal index would be between 1.0 and 1.4, meaning healthy arteries, at least based on blood pressure. 0.9 to 1.0 is also acceptable. However, if your numbers are 0.8 or less, you probably have plaque and it's probably causing blood flow obstruction and maybe even higher blood pressure. Also, an index higher than 1.4 indicates hardening of your arteries. Again, another problem. So you don't want it too high or too low. Now, wait a minute. What does all this have to do with arms and ankles? Well, you have arteries almost everywhere in your body. Compared to arteries in other places, arteries from your legs have bigger challenges. They're more narrow. They depend on your leg muscles to stay flexible. This, by the way, is one more reason not to be sitting all day. By measuring the blood pressure in your arms and comparing that with blood pressure in your ankles, we can find out if you have arterial plaque that's obstructing or hardening your arteries. That would be called peripheral artery disease, or PAD. PAD can be terrible. It causes cramps, pain, swelling, and even hair loss in your legs. Why? Because any part of your body that doesn't receive enough blood is going to die slowly. In PAD, the muscles, nerves, and even hair follicles are slowly dying due to loss of blood supply. And we know that people with PAD have a much higher risk of heart attacks and strokes. Now, remember, the problems here are number one, loss of blood flow to the muscles of the legs, and number two, the risk of clots. The risk of clots is demonstrated by a signal of too much plaque. Too much overall plaque can mean that there's a lot of soft plaque. Soft plaque can rupture, creating a clot, and cause a heart attack. What should you do after getting your results? If your numbers are good, congratulations, you might have some good, healthy arteries. However, I don't recommend just sitting on it. Pun intended. ABI is good for finding severe problems, not so much for subtle problems. And people that have heart attacks often just have only subtle problems. So we have other options to detect subtle plaque problems. If your results are not good, I'm glad you realized it. And you realized it today. There's no better time to take action than now. Let's go back to the scenario from the beginning. Imagine you're leaving the cardiologist's office after being told to take a statin and that's going to fix your problem. You're confused, worried about dying from a heart attack, and worried about how a pill can fix this problem. Now that you've seen this video, you'll understand the importance of doing the right tests. You'll know what to do first to understand your plaque. But if you want to know more about the lifestyle changes you can do to reverse or at least reduce, but most of all, reliably stabilize that plaque, take the risk off the table, check out how I did it here in this video.